In this video, we will show you how to set up your RME audio interface with FL Studio. Before we continue, install the driver for your RME interface. If you haven't done this already, you'll find the link to our downloads page and the appropriate driver in the video description. After the successful driver installation, open up FL Studio and go to Audio Settings. Select your RME interface as the audio device. Next, you can choose the sample rate. A sample rate of 44.1 kHz is perfect for most situations. With buffer length, you can optimize the performance of FL Studio in conjunction with your RME audio interface. Depending on the buffer, CPU load will increase or decrease. A smaller buffer needs more CPU power and vice versa. FL Studio itself suggests a buffer length between 10 milliseconds and 40 milliseconds. Try out for yourself which settings are the best on your computer. To record a signal, go to the mixer and select the channel and the input from which you want to record. Arm the track in the mixer and hit record. When asked, select audio into the playlist as an audio clip if you want the audio clip straight into your session. If you don't hear anything, make sure that your FL Studio master output is routed correctly. Note that all output channels in FL Studio will show up as software playback channels in TotalMix FX. If you are not familiar with this concept, please watch our dedicated series. Thanks for watching.